Hey, you guys. Hey. I think we need to talk about being in our 40s. Women, I need to talk to you. I need your advice, your help, because I know my demographics here on my channel. We're at least in our 40s. Maybe you're 25 and up. But if you're in your 40s or you've done the 40s,
sleep deprivation
is something I would love to talk about, among other things. But first, I have to go pick up a hot spot for my children. I finally got one through their school, and they gave me a 2-hour window this morning from 8 to 10 a.m. And I got the message at 9 a.m. I'm not gonna get up if I'm not gonna get stuff done if I'm out of the house this early. So I'm actually gonna go to Costco after this and possibly Target, and we'll explain that in a minute. But run all my errands, and I think I'm gonna make it home before the girls get off their last Zoom calls. Well, their morning Zoom calls. Here's the deal with where I've been. Went and got Jason his pumpkin pie, some oranges and some bananas, basics for Costco. We're actually stocked up on a lot of different things. But I also went and got this cute sweater from Target. It's a, what do you call it, zebra print? Oh, dang it, I have a light, hang on. Okay, I have a long light now. So, anyway, Randy got that sweater, and then I got Jason his pumpkin pie, and like literally he was like, if you don't do anything else today, just do that. Oh, I have another light. Bah. This is called chat with me between the lights. Okay, here's the thing though. Okay, so first of all, I got the sweater because we're doing our family portraits on Sunday. I'm gonna go through the next light, and I can already see it's red, so I'm gonna just slowly go up here while we talk. So I got a sweater for myself. I'm gonna go home and see if I can coordinate outfits for the rest of the kids. They're easier, they have a ton of clothes. I can try and see if I can put something together. If not, I might run them to the store today. So let's get back to being over 40, because I think it's starting to become a thing where I'm not sleeping at night, and it's a thing. It's not just because I'm having caffeine during the day. It's not just, I mean, I don't know what the deal is, because I took a solid nap yesterday afternoon. Like, I was exhausted because the night before, and again last night, I don't fall asleep until 3 a.m. I try and I try and I try, and I don't look at my phone beyond like 12:30. And last night I took a double dose of melatonin, and it, I mean, 2 hours later, it still hadn't done anything. It's supposed to work in 10 minutes. So we're almost home. So I'm just gonna keep talking, because I have to do schoolwork with the kids when I get there. So, is it a thing? Like, when you're over 40, I'm 43, it's a thing, but is it a thing that like you start to like not be able to go to sleep? Because from a few people that I've talked to, it's a thing. And it's like last night, it was driving Jason and I nuts. Because I think right when we were actually like starting to nod off around 3 a.m., Chelsea came into the room and was like, my watch alarm won't stop going off. Can you hang on to it? And set it on my dresser. And I was so tired that I didn't even like pay attention. So for the next half hour, that watch alarm went off every 5 minutes until I finally hid it in a bucket in the, underneath clothes in my closet and shut the doors. But I was like, you gotta kid me. I was just getting to sleep at 3 in the morning, and now I'm wide awake again because I had to get up and move around and... there. I can continue my conversation. I now have a hotspot for all of my kids. Hopefully it works. They haven't actually done a call since I got it all hooked up. They're at lunch break and my older girls don't have school today. Now I get to order. This is just life of a mom. You know, do stuff on the computer at the same time I'm doing stuff on my phone, the same time I'm doing stuff with you guys. For those of you who are over 40, and I'm not calling you out if you're not over 40, I'm not calling you out if you are. I'm just wondering if it's a thing. Like, my biggest problem right now is being in my 40s is not sleeping at night. Like I said, I turn everything off at like 12:30, close my eyes because they're tired, and then I take melatonin and it doesn't work. And hours later, we're still awake. Like, and my husband's the same way. He was up at 3 a.m. with me. It's just really annoying to not get any sleep. Like, I seriously started the day with caffeine at like, I don't even know what time it was, 10:15. I never do that. I never have caffeine before even like 2 o'clock these days because I don't need it. Today I was like, nope, there is no way that I can function without, and maybe I need to like go on a detox and not have it in my system. Either leave me a comment below letting me know you're in the same boat and you don't know what to do, or leave me a comment in the section that you are in the same boat and you know what to do. Because I need a solution and I need it because I need sleep. This is a funny story. So I got an extra, what do you call it, Echo Dot, went on, what was it, Amazon Prime Day, because I have to get my daughter a book, The Hate You Give. She's reading that for her advanced language art class. She needs probably a physical copy of it, actually.
I'm gonna have to rewind this. I have no idea what I was just saying.
Oh, okay. So we got an Echo Dot on Amazon Prime Day because it was like $18. And they're normally like, well, it was actually the newest generation one too. Like a huge savings on them because I wanted one in my bedroom. I wanted to see if we could do like night sounds, or I love to hear waves crashing and I love to hear like light music and stuff when I go to sleep sometimes. And so I wanted to see if that would help me sleep better. It helps my husband, but he plays it on his phone and then earbuds, and then he has to wake up and take them off, and that wakes him up, so it doesn't make any sense to do it that way. So I got the Echo Dot play music because you can set a timer and it'll automatically just turn itself off. And so we got it. I installed it yesterday or the day before. I accidentally added our device for our bedroom into a bedroom group, but for whatever reason, it lumped Abby and Kaylee's Echo Dot into our bedroom. So anytime we turned on music, it was automatically playing on in their room. And as a joke, we didn't know it was happening. So Jason wanted to like test it.
Hey, my kids' alarm's going off. They should be home soon from lunch break.
So just to test it and kind of give the girls a hard time to see if this was actually happening, like if we were turning on certain music, if it was going to their Echo Dot, he was like, turn on sexy music. And it was like, I don't even remember what the song was, but it was definitely like a type of song. And the teenagers came rushing into our room. What are you playing on our Echo Dot? It was so funny, because then it would just start playing because they were starting to play music. Anyway, I finally figured it out at like, it was seriously like 1 a.m. last night that I had put these two devices into one group. So I split them apart and it was just funny. So maybe tonight, now that we figured that out, we can play some calming music and take some melatonin. I feel like we joked last night because one of us would get to sleep and then the other one was still awake, and any movement would wake the other person up. And he was like, that's it. I'm moving into twin beds. He's like, my grandparents actually did that. They one slept upstairs and one slept downstairs for probably the last 20 years. I don't even know, because they woke each other up at night as they slept separately. And he's like, I'm getting separate beds. I need some sleep. So that we don't have to have separate beds. You guys, give us a solution down below, because I'm laughing now, but if I sat down on the couch, I would pass out. And it's only 12:43. Ooh, we have the nightly shadows on my face. It is now 6:30 p.m. I spent the afternoon watching a show and doing my nails. You see it's like dark green. Figured that would be kind of fun for Halloween and the first week in November. So I think I was doing them over here. Let's see if I don't think you'll be able to see the dark color. Nope, it's not gonna focus. But I just got back from taking Kaylee to an appointment, and I knew we'd be getting home late, but we left well before dinner. And so I went and picked up Cafe Rio for three of us. Abby, are you finding something to eat? A quesadilla, which is what I could have gotten her at. Do you like their quesadillas or no, Abby?
What?
Do you like Cafe Rio's quesadillas or no?
No.
I'm gonna let her eat, and I'm gonna eat myself. You always get extra sauce. I'm gonna eat really quick and then we'll come back and chat. Forgot to say hi to you. I mean, I have, but on the camera. Dude, I got you dinner. Don't pretend like I'm ignoring you. And it's always so weird to like see him watching my videos, even though I watch him over and over again when I'm editing.
I have to see how you edited our life.
Yeah, because you don't live it. You're not part of it. Did you have a good day?
Your leg warmer?
No. Okay. All right, actually, I want to show you something really quick. Jason's finished with his salad now. Look how much pie is left. And Jason just barely got home. Like, they destroyed that pie. I guess I should have gotten two, but it's probably better that I didn't. It's probably a lot better that I didn't.
Okay, well, we're back almost where we started this morning. I realized about an hour ago that I have book club tonight. And luckily, it is virtual, and I hadn't taken my makeup off. So, we are discussing America's First Daughter, about Thomas Jefferson's daughter, which was an excellent book, and I highly recommend it. So we just get to log into a Zoom call, and there's only a few of us that are gonna do it. That book was really long, but it was really good. So again, I highly recommend it. So I'm gonna try and go to bed as soon as I'm done with this book club tonight, because I wanna try and get a better night's sleep. What are other things that like happen to you when you're in your 40s? What other things do I have to not look forward to so that I can be more prepared? I don't know, that may sound stupid, but the whole like sleep thing is like throwing me off big time. So I mentioned earlier today that we were gonna get our family portraits done. That was kind of a last minute decision because I found a picture that a friend of mine who's a photographer posted on Instagram, and I just fell in love with her location. Like, I was blown away. It was perfect for our family. I will do a behind the scenes when we do go get our family pictures done. My father-in-law is taking our pictures, has done our pictures for a couple years now, because he's really good at it and can kind of do it last minute like this when I'm like, oh, we can go do it, because he needs stuff to do too. He loves to take pictures and edit them and have fun with them, and then he has updated pictures of his grandkids and his kids. So it kind of works to all of our advantage to have him take our pictures 6 minutes. So that'll be fun on Sunday. I'm trying to gather up clothes and outfits to wear. I don't like to do matchy-matchy, neither do the kids. We're out of that phase of life. I don't care if they wear a hoodie or a sweatshirt. Because it's also COVID, you know, that's kind of our year. I wasn't gonna do them because it's like, do we want to remember this year? But we've grown as a family, and I want to document that, and I want to remember all the things that we've gone through this year and that we're stronger on the other end of it. So I'm gonna put them in Christmas cards and send them off. If you want a Christmas card, let me know in the comment below. You'd have to send me at your address over on Instagram, but I am more than happy to send you Christmas cards if you want, because that's kind of fun to get in the mail. I won't tell you what my return address is. I always enjoy getting Christmas cards, and I kind of have a feeling that this year that's gonna get put on the back burner a lot. I think if anything we could do for each other this year, when everything is so different and we're all spaced apart, we can't have Christmas parties and activities and all that kind of stuff, the least we could do is see pictures of families in the mail and connect with each other that way, because we can't connect physically. We can't have big groups. We can't have our normal activities. Hopefully people will still do Christmas cards. Anyway, that's kind of it. More of a chatty type of video today, but I hope you guys are doing good. We will talk to you guys later.